Samsung Electronics vows to democratize artificial intelligence for Filipinos. The firm believes the technology would be a game changer for the local electronics sector. Its president, Min Si Chu, however, acknowledges achieving this goal will come with challenges.
AI is like kind of a tool to solve very complex issues, including like language barriers, analysis of the data, and then provide the proper recommendations and so on. Mm-hmm. And for us, we embedded these AI technologies in every product. There are several challenges in adapting those new technologies as well. Mm-hmm. Well, first and foremost, like infrastructure is one of the challenges in order to fulfill all the consumers' need, because technological development is stem from like connectivity. Mm-hmm. And number two is awareness of all those new technologies. Number third is adoption of the new technologies. So we try to understand what consumer.
The Securities and Exchange Commission giving companies that fail to submit their annual reports on time a chance to restore their good standing. The regulator has been strictly imposing higher fines and penalties to encourage habitual compliance with reportorial obligations. With the Enhanced Compliance Incentive Planner, ECIP, delinquent businesses can resolve their violations by settling penalties at reduced rates. Under the program, non-compliant corporations can pay a fee of 20,000 pesos, while suspended or revoked entities can settle 50% of their assessed fines. Applications for the ECIP will be accepted from September 2 to November 30 of this year. Malacañang has suspended government work in Metro Manila and Calabarzon today, but the Senate says work will resume Tuesday due to various scheduled committee hearings and plenary sessions. It adds employees whose service are essential for the conduct of hearings are required to report to work. Over at the lower house, it's also business as usual. House Secretary General Reginald Velasco said the chamber will continue essential legislative work, but he says employees who are gravely affected by the storm are excused from their duties. Over 600 families currently taking shelter in evacuation centers in Quezon City. Liza Aquino joins us for more. Hi, Liza, go ahead.
Good morning, Mimi. More than 5,400 individuals were evacuated in 20 barangays in Quezon City after several areas were flooded due to Enteng and the enhanced southwest monsoon. Most of the evacuees are residents of District 4 of the city. In Barangay Tatalon, one of the villages in the said district, around 553 families spent the night in Justado Macapagal Elementary School, while 120 families were evacuated in Doña Josefa High School. Mimi, the affected families were given food and modular tents where they can sleep overnight. But some residents, like Rowena Imbile, is calling for more help after their home got submerged again in waist-deep floods yesterday. Her family is still trying to get back on their feet after Super Typhoon Karina destroyed their home last July. As of this morning, most of the affected residents are still staying in different evacuation centers, awaiting further instructions from the city's Disaster Risk Reduction Office. Pag-asa earlier issued an orange rainfall warning within Metro Manila and is advising residents in the said area to monitor possible flooding. But as of now, Mimi, we've monitored some of the areas, and authorities say that there is no flooding in major roads in the city as of this hour. Back to you, Mimi.
Thank you very much for that update, Liza Aquino. The body of a 16-year-old girl who went missing on Sunday evening at the height of Typhoon Enteng after supposedly jumping in a creek in Parañaque City has finally been found in a nearby river. Job Banahan with the details. Hi, Job. What can you tell us?
Mimi, the family of the 16-year-old is mourning her death as authorities confirmed that the body found at a river beside Marcelo Compound in Barangay Moonwalk, Parañaque City this Monday afternoon is hers. The victim was identified as Rian Ivanho, a resident of Barangay Tambo in Parañaque City. According to Barangay San Isidro, the village where the creek was located, she was with her boyfriend and her boyfriend's brother for a drinking session when the incident happened. Juanita Aguilar, a VAUSI officer at the barangay, said the girl and her boyfriend's stepbrother jumped in the creek nearby the house around 11 p.m. on Sunday, and only the latter was able to go back to the land. Aguilar stressed that the circumstances surrounding the incident is still being investigated by authorities. Her body was found at a river beside Marcelo compound in Barangay Moonwalk, Parañaque City on Monday afternoon after residents saw a floating body in the waters. This was when residents swam in the water to rescue her, but she was already lifeless. Rian Ivanhoe's family is still in shock with what happened and told the media that they weren't informed she would be in a drinking session in Barangay San Isidro. Her aunt described Rian as smart and dedicated. She said her body is currently undergoing autopsy in Cavite. Meanwhile, just for a very short weather update, Mimi, heavy downpour is currently lashing parts of Quezon City and Manila as of this 9 a.m. In Manila, we monitored gutter deep floods along Rizal Avenue nearby Blumentritt Street following hours of heavy rains in Manila. Light vehicles can still pass the area. There is no flooding in España Boulevard and the University Belt. However, we advise motorists to be careful as there was almost zero visibility when we passed by the road. NDRRMC as of 6 a.m. raised the orange rainfall warning in Metro Manila, saying residents should be prepared for flooding or landslides in their area. That is the latest news that I have. Back to you, Mimi.
Thank you very much for that update, Joe Banahan. At least 13 people are killed amid the wrath of Tropical Storm Enteng. The storm slammed into the main islands of Luzon and Visayas on Monday, resulting in massive flooding and landslides. Four people, including a pregnant woman, were killed in a landslide in Antipolo, while the bodies of three other victims of drowning were recovered in three areas of the hilly community. The Bicol city of Naga was also hit hard, with a man electrocuted as floodwaters rose and a nine-month-old baby drowning. Twin landslides also killed two people and damaged five houses in the central city of Cebu. The Office of the Civil Defense says the number of fatalities could still rise as it continues to receive reports from storm-affected areas. As of Monday night, over 37,000 families have been affected by Enteng, with damage to infrastructure pegged at 200,000 pesos. That's very preliminary. That number is still expected to rise. Meanwhile, government has yet to release estimates on damage to agriculture. Tropical storm Enteng continues to move west-northwestward over the West Philippine Sea. The center of Enteng was last estimated over the coastal waters of Lawag City, Ilocos Norte. Moving west-northwest at 20 kilometers per hour, it is packing winds of up to 75 kilometers per hour near the center, with gustiness of up to 115 kilometers per hour. Signal number 2 remains up over Ilocos Norte. The northern portion of Ilocos Sur, Apayao, Abra, the northern and western portions of Kalinga, and the western portion of mainland Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands. While signal number 1 is up over the rest of Ilocos Sur, the northern portion of La Union, the rest of Kalinga, Mountain Province, Ifugao, the northern portion of Benguet, Batanes, the rest of mainland Cagayan, the rest of Babuyan Islands, the northern and western portions of Isabela, and the northern portion of Nueva Vizcaya. The enhanced southwest monsoon also expected to bring moderate to intense rainfall in other areas of Luzon, especially along the western portions over the next 3 days. Severe tropical storm Enteng is expected to leave the Philippine area of responsibility by Wednesday morning, then intensify into a typhoon on Thursday as it makes its way to China.